Hello students, let's do one numerical integration problem. This is from your textbook, example 3. The question is, find the value of integration over the range 0 to 6, 1 by 1 plus x dx by Simpson's 1/3 rule, and hence find the value of log 7. Log 7 value we get when we integrate this with analytical way of integration. Okay. So, let's do first analytical way of integration, then we apply Simpson's 1/3 rule to integrate this, okay? That is numerical way. So, let first do analytical way of integration of this. As we know, 0 to 6, 1 by 1 plus x dx. So, here fx is 1 by 1 plus x. So, if we apply the substitution method, that means let us take 1 plus x is equal to t. So, your original integration 0 to 6 will become 1 by t. Now, in place of dx, we need to write it in t form. So, differentiating both sides with respect to x, what we get dx is equal to dt. So, in place of dx, we write dt. So, your original integration will become this. As we know, integration of 1 by x dx is log x. So, integration of 1 by t dt will be log of t. T is what? 1 plus x. So, it is 1 plus x. And the limit is 0 to 6. Now, if we apply the limit, what will we get? Log of 1 plus upper limit. We need to put the upper limit first. So, 1 plus 6 minus log of 1 plus 0. So, it is a log of 7. So, we get, that means integration of this, integration of 0 to 6, 1 by 1 plus x dx is equal to log 7. The base is a. So, we get this log 7. Now, we are asked to find the value of log 7. So, integration of this by analytical way, we get integration of this is log 7. Now, if we find this integration by numerical integration method, and then whatever be the value of this integration, that will be the value of log 7. So, in this way, we can find the value of log 7. So, let's do the same problem by using numerical integration method. So, as we know, for numerical integration method, we don't need the fx form. What we need the table, x, fx table, okay. So, here x value, that means the lower limit is 0. So, we start with 0. Next will be 0 plus h. What will be h value? So, for h, we need to find h value. From the question, what is x naught is 0. Then, x naught plus NH is 6. We need H value, na? So we are doing this. So if we take the difference of X naught plus NH minus X naught, so it will be 6 minus 0. So this will cancel. What we get? NH is equal to 6. Now we need H value. What will be H? H is equal to 6 by N. So, we need, as we are asked here, to apply Simpson's 1/3 rule, so n should be multiple of 2. So, it can be 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, any value, okay? 2 is very small because we didn't get all the entries values. So, we don't use 2. 2 is very small. So, generally in numerical integration, we start with from 4. 4, 6, okay. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, like that. So, here as we are using Simpson's 1/3 rule, so here n should be multiple of, n should be multiple of 2. So, it will be 4 or 6 or 8 or 10, like this. So, here, look here, h is 6 by n. If we take n is equal to 6, it will be very convenient for calculation purpose because we get h is equal to 1. as we have to do this without calculator, so better if we take n is equal to 6. So when we take n is equal to 6, h will become 1. Now we can easily write this x value, that means 0 plus h is 1, so next value will be 1. The next value will be 1 plus 1, that is 2. 2 plus 1, that is 3. 3 plus 1, that is 4. 4 plus 1, that is 5. And 5 plus 1, that is 6. So we get the different values of x. That means we divide the whole range 0 to 6 into n equal parts. N equal parts means how many parts are there? 6 parts. Look, first part, then second part, third part, fourth, fifth, sixth. So we divide the whole range into 6 equal parts. But here ordinate are 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So ordinate are 7. When we are asked to take 7 ordinate, that means we are asked to divide the whole range into 6 equal parts. Okay. Now, for different values of x, we need different values of fx. Okay, so as we know, fx is what? From the question, we know that fx is 1 by 1 plus x. This is our fx value. So when we put x is equal to 0, fx will be 1. Next, when we put x is equal to 1, fx will be half, that means 0.5. Next, when we put x is equal to 2, fx will be 1 by 3, so it will be like 0.33 something. Like this, we complete this table, and after that, we apply Simpson's 1/3 rule to find the integration of this. Here, these are your ordinates. So, first ordinate, this is your last ordinate, y6. Next will be y1, y2, y3, y4, y5. So when we say first ordinate, that means this ordinate, last ordinate means this ordinate. When we say odd ordinates, odd means y1, y3, y5. These are odd ordinates. And even ordinates are y2. These are even ordinates, y2, y4, y6. So these are called even ordinates. But we don't repeat the ordinates there in the formula, okay? Because once we include this y6 in the first and last ordinate, we include this in last ordinate, so we don't take y6 again in the even ordinates, okay? So the rest part you can easily do, just apply the formula of Simpson's 1/3 rule and evaluate the value of this integration, and that whatever be the value of the integration, that will be the value of log 7. Okay, thank you.